What's up, my friends?
What's up, Facebook family?
I wanted to send out a quick message. I know I haven't been on as much lately. I've had a lot going on. And wanted to send out a message today. Today is all about we become what we focus on. And it was interesting. I woke up today with actually a friend from like many years ago that was friends with my brother posted like a really negative comment on my page. And it was interesting to me. In the past, I would have deleted it or ignored it or not put much focus on it. But I'm in a place now in my life where, since I've done a lot of this deep work, I have to draw a boundary. I have to communicate. I have to get it out now and handle things in the moment versus waiting to leather. So if anybody is watching and you've noticed any passive aggressive behavior in yourself, passive aggressive behaviors when we don't stand up for ourselves in the moment and instead we withdraw or we hold back or we don't communicate our truth, and in not having a voice, not communicating our truth, we end up being passive and beating ourselves up later. So I've shifted a lot of that energy in my life, and when something doesn't feel right, I speak my truth, even if it kind of is a little sloppy at first. So I had something this morning where somebody had written a negative comment, and I just wanted to share this because what I see is I see a man who went through a really tough breakup, and now he's really angry, and he's not feeling. And so instead he's focusing on the injustices of the world and getting so consumed with what he doesn't think is right in the world and trying to be an activist, if you will, that he's seeing red. I almost feel like he's seeing red and all he can see is red. So if it's anything to do with America, like he was calling me a KKK and KKK and a white supremacist and all these things, and very critical and judgmental. And I had a lot of compassion, because I could feel his pain. I could feel what he was hurting from. And I think he just has become so focused on this thing that he's become it. He's become the hate that he's become the hate, if you will. And he's now becoming it. So I wanted to just share that is, what are we focusing on? You know, we become what we focus on. Are you focusing on what you're grateful for? Are you focusing on what's missing? Are you focusing on what you have? Or are you focusing on what you don't have? Are you focusing on, you know, the hate in the world and the things that you can't change and you're angry about and why there's things wrong? Or are you focusing on what you're grateful for and what you do have and that you can see and that, you know? So there's a lot to be grateful for. There's a lot to focus on what we do have. And there's a lot that we can focus on that doesn't work. And it's our choice. It's your choice to figure out what we're going to focus on. So a couple messages is, one, we become what we focus on. If we focus on gratitude, we get more and more grateful. If we focus on hate, we get more and more hateful. It's just a good reminder. I think another good lesson is, you know, for those of you that are passive aggressive, stand your truth. I don't have an uncomfortability anymore in speaking up and for conflict, and I'm okay with it. This specific experience of a man who I had conflict with kept going, and I even took it to a personal message and it wouldn't stop. And I just eventually saw that he just wanted to fight. He was just angry and wanted to fight. It wasn't about communication. It was about fighting. But I ended up blocking him, which I usually don't do, because it just kept escalating, and he kept kind of escalating what he was calling me, which is not okay. And it's my boundary now. So I just wanted to share the message. You know, it came up. It was something that showed up this morning, and I know other people may be dealing with this where something's not okay. And how do you communicate your voice? How do you communicate your boundaries? So it's a lesson on communication. It's also a lesson on what we focus on. And I think the third lesson, which is important, is when somebody's in intense judgment, like I saw this man, I'll give you a little bit of the story so you understand the context and you can look through the lens that I'm seeing through now. As I see this man, anytime I see somebody in judgment is a protector from the heart. And when it's, to me, it's a very similar energy of, like, I think the shootings, and I think a lot of this energy, what's going on in the world of people shooting, judgment, anger, intense rage outward is really this poor wounded child inside of us that we've been wounded when we're hurting, and we don't have the tools to process. We don't have the tools to take away that pain. And we've been taught that the pain is wrong. We've been taught that we can't feel the pain. We've been taught that, oh, this pain I'm feeling, there's something wrong. I can't feel it. So we try to cover it up, and that cover up is the problem. The solution is in accepting that there's parts of ourselves that may feel pain, that may feel weak, that may feel wounded, that may feel broken. And learning to be gentle and loving and accepting and compassionate with ourselves and accepting those parts of our life that we may not change, that may be painful forever. And if we can learn to be more gentle and learn to be more accepting of those parts of ourself, that it bring us more peace and more gentleness and more compassion. I find then when we go into the world, we're not judging others. We're not comparing others. We're looking at others, and we're able to bring love and light. Even I have this man, it's an intense judgment towards me. And I could just see him like, oh, he's in his head. He's in his head. The fact that he's in judgment with me is already shows me he's in his head, right? If he would have been in his heart, he would have been very loving, very compassionate, very gentle. Hey, Susan. Hey, Christian. Hey, Ricky. Hey, Wendy. So I think that's the lesson. The lesson is we become what we focus on. If we focus on hate, we become hate. If we focus on gratitude, we become grateful. You know, if we focus on what's not working and fear and scarcity and lack and what's not working, we become scared and tense and our body tenses up and we're like, oh, nothing's working. And oh my God, I don't have enough money and the world's falling and our government's ruining the world and all these things people tend to focus on. Hey, Carrie. Then guess what? That's going to be your reality. That's what you're going to see. That's the lens you're going to look through. You're going to see news stations everywhere. You're going to hear comments. Everything's going to trigger you because we're riding this intensity of what's happening. If we focus on, I'm so grateful to be alive. I can see, I can smell. What's up, Ryan? I can hear, I can see, I can smell. I can talk, I can walk. There's so much to be grateful for. I have people in my life. I can still breathe. I have this body that's serving me. There's something to be grateful for. If I can focus on gratitude, even in the midst of my sheer pain and hell, if you're going through it, that's, I find, what you start to become is you start to become gentle. You start to become compassionate. And there's no need to fight. So I just wanted to share this. If you're just getting on now, I was sharing an instance of somebody who had a lot of negativity who came at me. And it was a lesson on boundaries. How to make sure you have healthy boundaries so that people don't walk over you. Like, I'm not about passive aggressive anymore. If somebody threatens me, I hold my boundary and I communicate my feelings, even if there's conflict. I know a lot of people have a challenge with communicating their feelings when there's conflict and will kind of be passive aggressive. And passive aggressive, what happens is later on it comes out and you attack yourself or you attack your kids or you attack your spouse, the people you love, because it's built up, pent up energy, and then you unleash it. So the way to shift passive aggressive energy, it's uncomfortable, but you need to speak your voice in the moment. You need to hold your boundaries. Communicate when things don't feel right to you. You need to communicate that. So there was a couple lessons from it. It was lessons on boundaries. It was a lesson on communicating your voice. It was a lesson on we become what we think. And it's also a lesson on lessons from the heart are, man, how can we have more compassion? Everybody out there that we see who's angry and mad at the world, like, they have a lot, they're hurt, you know? So how can we, instead of getting, when they come at us, how do we hold our boundary and not let that energy come towards us? But how do we be more gentle and more loving and more compassionate that they're just hurt? You know, they're hurt if they're acting out. It's their way of trying to take because they don't feel enough inside. And they're trying to take that energy to feel enough because they don't feel enough. And how can we be gentler towards those people? So I just want to share an interesting message. Sorry, I've been a little bit MIA. Things have been a little crazy. I'm flying out. I'm moving today. I'm flying tomorrow. I'm going to the mountains for a couple months. And I'll still be online, but I'll be in the mountains, where it's a little bit calmer and quieter. And then I'm going to spend 3 days filming. So I'll be doing some snapshots or some things of what we're filming so we can finish the documentary. And I'll be back next week. So just wanted you guys to send this message. Have healthy boundaries. Focus on what you're grateful for. Speak up. Speak your truth. Speak your voice. And live from the heart. And have a beautiful, blessed day. Much love.